We're in Coventry tonight, the Sky Dome, a brand new venue opening its doors to boxing for the very first time tonight. But the sport's enjoying a bonanza in these parts these days. The fans have some big local names to get behind. And tonight, the city hosts a British title fight for the first time ever. Yes, the British light heavyweight title vacated by Clinton Woods, but he wasn't going down, he was going up. He's still the European champion and aiming for even bigger things. I'm delighted to say he joins Nicky Piper here. Great to have you with us. I just wonder if you see a little parallel with your own career 2-3 years ago and the frustrations and the two men who fight on our top of the bill tonight.
Well, yeah, it was very similar. 3 years ago, I was fighting on small shows, winning fights, and then I got me a Commonwealth fight against Baker. I beat Baker, and then I went up from there. Baker went back. Well, Baker got a few title shots himself, but he kept coming up short.
They've paid their dues, both of them, though, haven't they, Clinton?
They're both very, very tough fighters. They know the game. And like today, tonight is a big chance to win the British title and then go on for bigger things.
Nicky, how do you see it?
Well, I see it being a really tough battle tonight. It could be scrappy, but I see it being very competitive. And tonight we saw the guys entering the arena, and they both looked quite relaxed. Simpson here, it will have been frustrating time for him, the late replacement. He was all geared up for Darren Corbett, a big punching, different style to Baker. But for Baker, it'll be a chance, he'll be ready for it. He's been sparring with Neil Simpson, so he'll know the style, he'll know exactly what to expect, and you can't say he won't be ready.
More from Nicky and Clinton as we go here tonight. That British light heavyweight title fight has got this arena buzzing. But first tonight, it will be the return of one of Coventry's best-loved heroes, Dean Pithy, who earlier this year featured in a thriller for the British super featherweight title. Pithy produced one of his best displays that night. Gomez expected a severe test, and he certainly got one. A great start for Pithy. Gomez down early on. But in the middle rounds, Gomez replied in kind.
Has Pithy on the floor with a right hand!
Well, that was a well-timed right hand from Gomez, and Pithy in a bit of trouble here.
Both men sustained hand injuries, and little wonder. An excellent fight, but Gomez applying enough pressure to get the decision. Still, Pithy had proved that he belonged in championship class, and that's where he wants to stay.
This is just to get me back on the platform, just to say to people, you know, I ain't going downhill from here. I'm going to come back with a bang, and like, you know, I'll be back up there with like knocking on Gomez's door and that within the next like 2-3 months.
Dropped the result that night, but no doubting Pithy has made a big improvement under the tutelage of Spencer Oliver, who again works with him tonight. Adam Smith is trying to muscle his way in for a word backstage.
Spencer, defeat is never easy to come back from, but Dean Pithy fought very well against Michael Gomez. How's his reaction been in the gym, in training?
I think that, if anything, he's benefited. You know, I think he answered a lot of questions in that fight. You know, when the chips were down, he come back strong. He had a broken hand for 4 rounds. So I think, if anything, he's done himself, you know, the world of good, and I think he can go on from here now.
Mentally, you think he's right, but what do you know about this wise man, Jim? Another strange fella from South Africa. Seen anything of him?
Yeah, we've seen a videotape of him, southpaw, leads off a lot with the left hand, come forward, rugged type of guy. Looks quite awkward, quite tricky, but Dean studied him a lot. He drops his right hand a lot, so I think the key shot in this fight will be the left hook.
What do you expect from Dean Pithy tonight?
I just expect him to go out there, and I expect him to look, you know, really good. And that's the game plan now. You know, he's come off a good, all right, he lost the fight, but he come off a good performance against Michael Gomez, and he's just got to go on from there now. And then hopefully we're calling out for the Michael Gomez fight again.
Wish you the best of luck.
Thanks a lot.
They're putting Pithy straight back in against international class opposition tonight. That's where they want him to stay. It's the unbeaten Wiseman Jim, who comes from South Africa, to try to make his name at Pithy's expense here. That's our first live action, cracking card here. Ringside for us. It's Ian Dark and Glenn McCrory. And Pithy will be on the way out here in front of his home crowd in just a moment or two, once John McDonald has announced him.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get the championship action underway now. Please welcome to the ring from Willing Hall in Coventry, where he is known as the Pitbull, Dean Pithy.
Well, as you can hear, big support again
for Dean Pithy on home territory. Can he rebuild his career? It was a thrilling fight when he lost his British title challenge against Michael Gomez, and he didn't lose too much in defeat, but the question hangs in the air, despite all the confident noises from the camp, Glenn. How much has that fight taken out of him physically and mentally, do you think?
Well, you would think it was a pretty tough fight for him, but I think mentally he may have grown for it. There was a point in a way he was hurt, he had a bad hand, but yet he still comes to that show, good character, and was there at the end, and I think he'll want to build on that. I think that would have given him a bit of confidence at that level. You know, Gomez is a good fighter, he want to build on that and go to better things.
Trained these days by Spencer Oliver, and I'm noticing no sign of Charlie Magri in the corner tonight. Charlie Magri, the former world flyweight champion who guided Pithy in the early stages of his career. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and welcome to the Sky Dome here in Motor City Coventry for tonight's championship boxing, proudly presented by Ringside Boxing Promotions and sponsored here by the Daily Star. And a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us live here on Sky Sports, our listeners here on TalkSport 1089, 1053 on the medium wave, and BBC Radio Coventry and Warwickshire. Welcome live to the Sky Dome. All the officials have been appointed by the WBF in association with the British Boxing Board of Control here present with us at ringside. Our fight supervisor is Mr. Robert Smith of London. Our two scoring judges from London, Dave Paris, from Derby, Paul Thomas, and our scoring referee and one of the leading referees in the world today from Wolverhampton, Mr. John Coyle. Our matchmaker is Mr. Graham Lockwood of Skipton. They are the officials, and here are the contestants. Firstly, and introducing to you, he's fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the white trunks trimmed with red. He weighed in at 9 stone and 4 pounds, bringing an undefeated professional record of 9 contests, 8 wins, 4 inside the scheduled distance, and 1 draw. He comes to the ring from the beautiful city of Cape Town in the Republic of South Africa, where he is known as the second to none, Wiseman Jim. And across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the silver trunks trimmed with blue and weighed in at 9 stone and 4 pounds. He brings a 23-fight record, 19 wins, 10 inside the scheduled distance, 3 losses and 1 draw. He comes to the ring as the former WBO Intercontinental and former WBC International Super Featherweight Champion from the delightful Winter Hall in Coventry, the Pitbull, Dean Pithy. Well, sports fans and Sky fans, and here we go then, 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBO Intercontinental Super Featherweight Championship.
First time I've heard Willenhall described as delightful, Glenn.
I don't know, I've never been there.
It's a tough area of Coventry. It's where Pithy comes from.
Mind you, obey the rules at all times and listen to my instructions. Shake hands. Good luck to you both.
Mind you, this Wiseman Jim comes from a pretty rough part of Cape Town as well, down in South Africa. He's a southpaw, pretty rugged, and he's due to have a South African title fight, I'm told. He's ranked number 2. At super featherweight in South Africa. That's the word from his camp, anyway. Called himself second to none after one of his heroes, Michael Nunn, the former world middleweight champion. Pithy with the blue trimmings on his waistband from Coventry here, and was on a good little run until he came a cropper against Michael Gomez. Hand trouble didn't help him that night, and I understand that right hand has still been giving him a little bit of bother in the build-up to this fight. Not too much, but there is a bit of worry in the camp.
Well, that will be a concern, and you know, he probably will have it in the back of his mind as well, Pithy. But you know, he needs to get his jab going and just, you know, find the style of Jim out. You know, he's tall, rangy, awkward, and fights out of the southpaw stance, so that can make life difficult for Pithy.
It's won 8 out of 9, Wise Man Jim, and that is his proper name. It's not been turned around for ring purposes or anything like that. Sounds a bit odd, doesn't it? But that's right, Wise Man Jim. Pretty exotic. He's 26 years of age, same as Pithy. They say he's a bit open to left hands. Let's see. If he is, he could be in trouble against Pithy, whose trademark shot is the left hook.
Yes, but the problem for Pithy is getting close enough to deliver that left hook against a tall, awkward opponent.
Pithy's camp might be a little wary too that another African, Andrew Matabola, delivered a shock defeat to Pithy with body shots, stopping him in the 8th round, although that defeat has since been avenged by Dean Pithy. There's that little risk when you're fighting the unknown quantity, even if you've watched the odd video.
Well, it's also difficult when your opponent's undefeated. You don't really know how good he could be.
Thumps in a right hand to the body. Quite rangy for the weight, by the look of him, Wise Man Jim.
Pithy has to try and get into range without getting hit on the way in. He's got to be wary of the, you know, the southpaw's left hand. Just make sure he doesn't walk onto that punch.
Pithy's agenda here is to try to engineer a rematch for the British title with Michael Gomez. He got there with a little left hook there. Looked like Jim wanted to hold on for a moment. Pithy says he loves fighting southpaws. Oh, well, about two punches after the bell. Then he hugs Pithy, who pushes him away. Hey, that's getting a bit spicy here.
Well, he just kept hitting Pithy. Pithy got very annoyed at that, pushed him off. He didn't like that at all, Pithy. A scratch on his nose as well. Took a few shots at the end of that round.
Certainly deliberately thrown after the bell as well. He was definitely taking a liberty.
Oh,
look at those. Two punches after the bell. Then he hugs Pithy, who gives him away. Oh, I think we got a instant replay there from somewhere.
Well, he wasn't very happy. The corner of Jim were trying to make amends, but Pithy didn't like it.
We're back live with you now. This is live, live, live. Here's the second round. Pithy on the far side from you. 19-3 his record so far, with one draw. Good wins over Paul Griffin, Carlton McKenzie, Andrew Matabola in the rematch, Frank Kiwanuka in a couple of rounds. But beaten by body shots against Gary Thornhill, the new British featherweight champion, and Andrew Matabola, and beaten on points by Gomez. So which way does Pithy's career go now? He's well past the learning stage. It's all about getting championships now for him. Struggling to find any rhythm, isn't he, so far, Pithy?
Well, he is. I think the problem is Jim's style. It's very, very awkward, and it's difficult for Pithy to get any sort of rhythm. And, you know, he needs the rhythm to get his punches off. He's that type of fighter. And now Jim just making it difficult for Pithy to get in range and land his left hook.
Bit of a Spider-Man, isn't he, the South African?
Yes, he's, you know, very long and very rangy and unorthodox. It's difficult when you're like that anyhow, but coming with behind the southpaw stance makes it doubly difficult.
He's got to watch that he doesn't get nailed by a left hand. He's got 4 knockouts in his 8 wins, Wise Man Jim.
Ooh.
missing a lot, Pithy, so far. Got there with that little right hand. No rhythm or timing. It was only 3 months ago, that hard fight with Gomez.
Yes, and he hasn't thrown a great deal of right hands. That's the punch he may be wary about throwing. But he needs to, you know, that's very, it's a good punch against the southpaw, the right. And that also measures your opponent for the left hook. So he needs to get that punch on and doesn't need to be hesitant about throwing it.
Covered up okay there, Dean Pithy. He's getting there with that southpaw jab here and there and the odd left hand. This could turn out to be a hardish night for Pithy if he's not careful.
And Pithy's got to find a way past the jab, he's got to get inside, he's got to start roughing Jim up and getting his own punches on.
Last few seconds of this second round. Difficult in there at the moment for Pithy, who's struggling to land with anything that effective. Three Sky Dome, first boxing they've ever had here, this new arena. And now then, this is what the computer is telling us so far. Pithy's landed 20, Jim's landed 25, he's thrown 179, three times as many. Only landed a few more. I've given him both the first couple of rounds myself, South African.
I've given that the same, it's just this erratic style is giving Pithy all sorts of problems.
So Dean Pithy in a little spot of early bother, though he got there with a good right hand. He needs to start throwing that, as Glenn was suggesting in the last round. It's the classic tactic against the southpaw, and I would suggest particularly this one.
Yes, it's going to be difficult for Pithy to score with the jab against somebody so long, and difficult with a lead left hook, so he really needs to try and get combinations together. The left right and the left hook is the right sort of combination.
Jim was badly cut in his last fight, but won a technical decision, so that'll be a little worry for them. And he gets there with body shots and looks very eager. And he wants this quite badly, and Pithy having to take shots to the body. Maybe they've heard about Pithy's supposed vulnerability to body shots. Now watch slapping, says referee John Coyle. He's punching with the inside part of the glove as opposed to the knuckle part of the glove for the non boxing aficionados.
Well, Jim's showing some aggression there. Actually, it may not be a bad thing for Pithy to let Jim come at him, and that would solve the problem of getting close to him. You know, he could try and just cover up and then look for his shot as Jim was on the attack.
Walks onto a right hand there, Jim. Left hand as well. He's really struggling, Pithy, here to work out this style. Big time. He must be a little bit worried in the corner there, Spencer Oliver. She's due to go 12 rounds. It's for one of those intercontinental titles, as recognized by an organization called the WBF. Who frankly don't mean a can of beans, so we won't worry about that. Left hook to the body from Pithy, just lost his balance there, wasn't he sure?
Yes, he just overthrew that punch a bit and threw himself off balance. Just trying to wind up the left hook there, Pithy. It's difficult against Jim because he also throws, as well as being erratic and orthodox, he throws a lot of punches. It's difficult for Pithy to set himself.
Very frustrated in there at the moment, I would suggest, Pithy. Jim's missing with quite a few himself, mind you. That's a bit better from Pithy.
He's getting a bit closer with his own right hand there, Pithy. But it's still Jim that's doing more of the work.
Right, six tournaments for you over the summer, featuring some of the great football entertainers
live from the Nottingham Arena Thursday night from 7:30 on Sky Sports 1. We have live boxing for you from Coventry here tonight. Light heavyweights late at the top of the bill, but Dean Pithy's found a tricky one from the look of it. Back to Glenn and Ian.
Yeah, I think you're right, Paul. This wise man, Jim, nearly didn't get in the country. He arrived without a work permit and had a long wait to clear immigration, as it were. At the moment, Dean Pithy, I think, is hoping and wishing that he hadn't got in the country.
Well, I think that Pithy hasn't got to get disheartened by the start. He's got to just keep to his game plan, trying to get in close. And really, when he gets in, he's really got to try and work hard.
More work rate from this wise man, Jim.
Some of these left hooks in there from Pithy, just short but effective.
One of Jim's victories in South Africa a couple of years ago was reckoned to be one of the fights of the year out there. He's managed by the same guy who brought Mzonke Fana over here. Pithy beat him on points over 12 rounds. So they know plenty about Dean Pithy, this camp. Maybe significantly.
Jim had a bit of trouble with his gum shield as well. It's a very big gum shield, and I'm trouble keeping it in his mouth, I think.
He looks as if he's got about a pound of cheese in there, doesn't he? Keeps on trying to come out.
Yeah, it looks like it's a full Dutch Edam in there.
He's not doing badly in the fight, though.
Well, he's very busy. I mean, I just don't know, you know, can he keep this sort of work rate up? I think it's difficult for Pithy, you know, to find a way in, because he is working that hard, Jim.
He's giving the impression that he's chewing gum in there. That is such a huge gum shot. His body shots again get in. Now, Dean Pithy has got to start doing something about this, otherwise he could fall to a horrible defeat here.
Well, he's allowing Jim to come forward. Somehow he's got to find a way of backing this man up. He needs to put him on the back foot, see if he can fight like that.
It just looks a bit flat as well to me, Pithy, as if that fight with Gomez might have taken quite a lot out of him emotionally. Should he have taken a longer break?
Well, I think that the problem in this fight is it's difficult for him because he's never getting into it yet. You know, had he getting into it, he may feel different, but he just can't find a way in.
Good right hand on the counter from Pithy, but it's a rare success.
Jim's picked him up with a couple of good left hands to Pithy's body, and that's made him pull the elbow in a few times, as if they've, you know, given him a little bit of pain.
Into the statistics from our computer again, and they're revealing. Look at that. Wiseman Jim has thrown nearly 400 punches in four rounds so far. He's only landed with 70 of them, but I reckon he's winning every round so far.
Yes, I agree with you, Ian, and you know, he's just throwing that greater quantity, and you know, they've been much more effective because there is so many of them. He just won't allow Pithy to get set to get his punches off.
Two judges at ringside, plus referee John Coyle, scoring here.
Well, I've given everything to Jim, the same as you, Ian. And, you know, he really is ambitious, this wise man, Jim.
He's got intertangled with the rope, shoots a glance at his corner, wise man, Jim, there for a moment. Quite a well-kept secret, this fellow. He's only had 10 fights in 6 years as a pro. Now, that means he's only half interested in the business, or they've been avoiding him a bit.
Well, that can often happen. People can just be hid away and you'll not have big records because people do not want to fight them.
I think he's struggled a little bit, so his management tell me, with not being linked up with the right kind of promoters over there.
And if you could get a win here, you could see maybe it'll be a bit easier to find a promoter.
That's better from Pithy. A couple of left hooks to the body. That's where he needs to be. getting in some of those left hooks to the body.
It really is going to take a big barrage of punch. He needs to take the fight out of Jim somehow, Pithy. And I think, you know, he's going to have to grit his teeth and start letting punches go. I think technically it's going to be difficult for him to find a way in.
It's a big problem in there at the moment for Dean Pithy. Just not hitting the highs he managed in his fight with Michael Gomez. That's a slip by the look of it. No knockdown. No knockdown and ruled as such by referee John Coyle. Now that's better from Pithy. That was his shot of the fight so far. That sort of looping overhand right. Needs more of that though. Plenty more of it. And that's a nice right-hand counter from Pithy too.
It's going to take a real grit and determination from Pithy here. This is going to really test his character and how much, you know, he wants to be back at a bigger level.
There's a nice right uppercut from him as well. Starting to just pick a few punches. Not quite so accurate in this round, Jim. Still can't get over that name. It's a weird one, isn't it? Wise Man Jim. I had to check it three times with the camp. The vacant British Light Heavyweight Championship being contested by Coventry's Neil Simpson on home ground against Mark Baker. Here, Dean Pithy in trouble against South African import Wiseman Jim, but maybe Pithy had his best round in the fifth. I just gave it to him.
Well, I give it a more of an even round. He did better, Pithy, but I didn't think he did enough to win the round. Jim is still throwing an awful lot of punches.
This is round six. It's due to go 12. I'd have thought 10 rounds would be a more sensible distance for a rehabilitation fight for Pithy, but I suppose with this Intercontinental Championship on the line, they have to make it the full 12. I like the old 10 rounders myself.
Yeah, I like that. I like them as well, Ian.
Pithy with the name of his son, 2-year-old son Shane, written on his trunks, as well as Coventry City FC, who had a great home record this season but were hopeless away. Well, Pithy's at home here, but he's behind, we reckon anyway.
Jim still so ambitious, taking the fight to Pithy. You know, he's the one that at this stage looks as if he wants it more.
His camp claim, his amateur record, was 68 wins and one defeat, Wiseman Jim. Never can tell about these things. There's a lot of talk, isn't there? But maybe.
Well, if it's true, it's a very good amateur record. And so far, he has turned out to be something of a wise man, this Jim. Had to get that in sometime, Ian.
Very clever, Glenn, yes. We'll let you know later. Not looking to carry any great power. They look like arm punches a lot of the time from Wise Man Jim, but my goodness me, he's throwing plenty of them. And Pithy, for long periods, not doing enough. It's the South African taking the fight to him nearly all the time.
Well, he certainly doesn't seem to have any worries about running out of gas, Jim. You know, he really is setting a torrid pace. Even if, you know, he's missing with a lot, he still keeps throwing. You know, he's not worried about the accuracy. He just lets them go.
Looks a bit puffy around the eyes, Wiseman Jim, but honestly, he looked like that when he got in the ring. Heads banging together.
think there's a right hand from Pithy went in there as well, which just seemed to trouble Jim for a second.
Pithy almost certainly has the extra power, but he just is unable to use it. So this is a crisis, isn't it? He's got a bit of damage there, Wiseman Jim, underneath that left eye. Now we get a closer look.
Yes, it is a crisis for Pithy. He's got to do something. It's all falling away from him. And yeah, he needs to get this fight back in control, in some sort of control. He's never had control.
Well, there you can see that Wiseman Jim, splendidly named South African, is landing far more punches and throwing a heck of a lot more. He's averaging about 100 punches a round.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Spencer Oliver, they must be getting a little bit anxious in there. Pithy just looks over to somebody at ringside. We might get a little word while this round's going on with Spencer Oliver, the trainer. A sort of word from the corner in running, as it were. So what can Pithy do about this? Well, we can go into the corner now. Spencer Oliver with Adam Smith.
Well, Spencer, Dean's having all sorts of problems with his southpaw style. What are you telling him?
He's very awkward, he's tricky. He's hurt Dean a couple of times downstairs, so we're telling him to keep his elbows tucked tight and then come back with short shots. Dean's got to open up as he's going, then Dean's got to come back at him. He's letting the guy lead off first and he's taking the play away from him. He's leading off first and then he's tying Dean up.
Do you think he's badly losing?
Who?
Dean.
No, I don't think he's badly losing. No, I think it's all pretty level at the moment. The kid's just a bit of a spoiler. Dean's doing a nicer work, but he's hurt Dean downstairs a couple of times. It's a worrying thing. But Dean's just got, the guy's starting to slow up now, and Dean's just got to start taking the play away from him.
Thanks a lot, Spencer.
Well, wasn't that interesting? He thinks it's kind of level. There's Glenn McCrory's scorecard. 5 points up, Wiseman Jim. I've got him 4 up.
Yes, I've got, you know, very difficult to Pithy anything for me. Jim is the one throwing all the punches and, you know, Pithy's struggling desperately here.
Good left hand from Jim there. Back came Pithy. A couple of wild left hooks from him. Just not enough accuracy. He's got to try and wear this lanky South African down somehow. There's still plenty of time left in the contest for him to do that. This is not an irretrievable cause. Good body shot from Pithy.
But Jim just isn't weakening, he's not slowing down. He's fighting at a torrid pace. You're missing with a lot of punches, but there's still plenty landing.
Can he keep up this pace, I suppose, is one question. We just don't know. A couple of body shots and a very big right hand from Pithy. Gets it with an uppercut as well, and a hook. Good shots here from Pithy, and the leg stiffened there of the South African. But somehow he just ploughs on forward and keeps throwing punches, even in the middle of that when he was rocked.
Well, that's what he needed, Pithy. He needed to find the chain. He needed to get some good punches on, and there were really good ones from Dean Pithy. That'll give him a bit more confidence. He's obviously getting a little bit closer to Jim and more able to get punches on.
That really was an impressive combination from Dean Pithy. Couple more body shots. He's just slowing a little, I fancy, now, this Wiseman Jim. Not quite as sprightly on his legs. One or two of these shots, I think, have just taken a bit out of him. I give that round a Pithy.
Yes, I agree. Some impressive shots in the middle of that round, and you know, they may prove valuable. They may have just shook Jim up a bit. Pithy will be hoping so. It was a good combination. Jim must be just starting to stand a bit closer to Pithy. So that was the first time Pithy was really allowed to get form with some good quality punches. And it was predominantly with the right hand. And that's the punch he hasn't really thrown an awful lot of.
It's a lot better from Pithy, this, isn't it?
Yes, it was a good right hook and then a lovely right uppercut, which really You know, really took something out of Jim, but he's tough and he comes straight back.
Seconds out, round eight.
Eighth round. Now, what does Dean Pithy produce here? He needs really to be picking up the rounds from here on in, because we think anyway that he'd fallen behind in the first half of the contest. Now, whether the two judges, Dave Parris and Paul Thomas, and referee John Coyle see it like that is another thing. So here we have a minor championship fight. We're Britain and a South African, and we've got three British judges for it.
Yeah, you wouldn't be that pleased if you were a South African, would you?
Nope.
Fit his head, I think.
Oh, he's good shots, good shots. Getting through, he's having a cover up. His head clears, he comes back with two body shots. Good rally from this Wiseman Jim, who looks very durable and extremely ambitious in the fight. No doubt about the fact that he's come here to chalk up a victory. Chance of Dino ringing around this new Sky Dome in Coventry City Centre.
Well, his home crowd are trying to lift Pithy. I think they sensed he was hurt there, and he needs lifting.
The eighth round was a bad round, remember, for Pithy against Gary Thornhill and Andrew Matabola. It's where he came a cropper, stopped in that round twice in the past. Good body shot getting in from Jim. An awkward customer, all right. The South African. That's a really good looking left hand. Mixes one up to the body as well. Catches Pithy again to the head. Looks like he wants it more, doesn't he, at the moment?
Pithy just using his head a little bit there inside. Referee quick to read the riot act to him.
Well, I think he realises he needs to do something to break the composure and rhythm of the man who comes from the shadow of Table Mountain.
He found a nice straight right hand there, Pithy. Picked that punch well.
Pithy in trouble in the early part of the round. He's come back quite well. I should think they were hoping for a reasonably or comparatively gentle rehabilitation job tonight and a nice win, but it's turning into a bit of a sort of life and death trench warfare struggling for him, isn't it, this?
Well, I think it's a lot harder a fight than he would have wanted and really needed. Well, it was a good start to the round from Jim. You heard him with a punch there, and then just keeps throwing punches. Pithy struggling to get out of the way. Some decent leg movement, but wasn't moving the head.
Spencer Oliver, the former European super bantamweight champion, in the corner.
A little bit animated there. Ah, Spencer. He'll be frustrated with this, very close to Dean Pithy.
36% success rate for Pithy, but he's landing with less. He's doing three times as much work, Jim, is what those stats prove. But a few of them landing with the inside of the glove, perhaps, and the referee's already indicated that at one point. So although we've got Wiseman, Jim, both Glenn and I, in a pretty handy lead here, there's no telling how the judges might be interpreting things. It's one of those, isn't it?
Yes, it could be interpreted a little differently because of the inaccuracy at times of Jim, but you know, just the sheer volume of, for me, he's still doing a lot more in the rounds.
Sharp left on the counter in there from Dean Pithy.
He just dipped his head a little bit and his arm fell out. He's got the feeling maybe he hurt that right hand, or he felt a bit of pain
from that right hand.
Maybe it's playing him up again. It's proving quite easy to hit in this phase of the fight, Pithy. And being made to look a shade one-dimensional. Rugged stuff over there in the corner.
Still looking for the body punches, Jim. He's trying to take the steam out of Pithy. Still a terrific pressure from Jim.
Well, I reckon they've done their homework, the South African camp.
Well, they look too off. You know, they're trying to rough Pithy about, they're trying to take it out of him physically and mentally, and you know they keep going for the body punches an awful lot, so I think they have done a good bit of homework on Pithy.
I'm sure the Wiseman Gym corner will be aware of the fact that they're boxing in the other fella's backyard as well. Everybody in the arena seemingly singing in support of Pithy now, trying to lift him, but he needs lifting too.
He's just never been able to find the rhythm or the style or, you know, get the gears to get into this fight, Pithy. I think that's been the biggest problem for him. Jim's pushed him onto the back foot, kept throwing punches, never really allowed him to get his balance. And it's just been such an uncomfortable night for Pithy.
This man constantly chewing like some batsman at the crease on his gun shield. Keeps on throwing punches, and I think that right hand of Pithy's is hurt. Coming up after this, the fight for the vacant British light heavyweight title, and another hometown hero here. Here he is, Neil Simpson, going in against Mark Baker. Late substitute, is this the night that Simpson brings the British light heavyweight crown to Coventry? They haven't had a British champion since the 1970s, days of Danny McAlinden and Bobby Arthur.
Well, getting a little closer, certainly on the body punches, 32 to 33. And you know, there's not that big a difference in the head punches, but you know, he's thrown so many punches, Jim, really has thrown an awful lot. But yet he's still, you know, he's not tiring. You know, he's fought at such a good pace.
Well, he's proved in the past he can go the rounds and fight hard. 10th round. I wonder if Pithy's camp were really expecting anything as difficult as this. Red stripe down the shorts of Wise Man Jim, who's adopted the Michael Nunn nickname of Second to None, the second to none, as it were. So far, that's proved true, because nobody's beaten him yet.
Oh, he really is true. I don't know if he's struggling with that gum shield in his mouth, but he's munching on it. Just careful he doesn't swallow it the way he's chewing it.
It's a full three-course meal, isn't it? Some of them are quite tasty, aren't they?
I've never really enjoyed chewing mine.
Back to the action. Left hand gets through again. From Jimmy's out of reach with his jab a bit. He misses a lot, but he's throwing so many that the impression all the time is that he's winning the rounds.
What he's managed to do is he's managed to mentally subdue Pithy and not, you know, not allow Pithy to have any confidence.
I'll tell you what, it would be some very charitable scoring indeed that would have Pithy even close, I'd say, at this stage.
Well, you would think so. I mean, this is a good performance from Jim, just not letting up.
Stop boxing! Sort it out. Stop boxing. Okay. Box.
he's lost a bit of heart in there, Pithy, as you can well expect. And even when he is close to Jim, he's not letting the punches go.
Particularly not the right hand, which we think could be hurt again.
Well, if he's having trouble with that punch, it's a big problem for him. Against a southpaw, you've got to look for that right hand to give you the leverage.
Get there with a left hook, though. Needs a breakthrough, needs to make a dent in this gangling southpaw from Cape Town.
Well, Jim's still chomping his way forward there, letting the punches go.
And chomping is the right word. A little left from Pithy, but a spasmodic success from him. Well, we think Pithy's in trouble here. Whether the judges, two of them, and the scoring referee, John Coyle, do is another matter. Now then, let's have a look at the last round here and watch for the right hand here of Dean Pithy, which we think's injured. This is seen from the last round, round nine. Watch him shake the hand, there.
Well, yeah, I mean, I thought I sensed a few rounds ago that he'd heard it, that there, you know, you could sense it was there. He twinged it because he dropped it after he threw it, and I thought that's where the problem was. But, you know, there's certainly nothing going right for Pithy. He can't get his jab on. Jim landed 47-5, and, you know, Pithy's jab almost non-existent.
Well, that's a really damaging stat, isn't it? Two rounds to go. And I've got this South African 6 points ahead.
Well, I've got him 7 points ahead. I think, you know, however, he's well on top.
So can Pithy do anything to rescue it? A dispirited and, we think, injured Pithy in the last couple of rounds. If he does get beaten here, it would be a bit of a nightmare. Fremy'd have to go back and try to rebuild yet again. He's done it in the past, but time's getting on, and you wonder how many more times he can suffer shock defeats, if that's the way it's going to be tonight. This is the man who still holds that distinction of being the last one to beat Nassim Hamed. At the age of 15 in the junior AVAs, the rematch is not imminent. Pithy could just do with one of his left hooks really landing on the button to maybe turn things around dramatically in his favour.
Yes, he could do with Jim, just stop throwing punches for a while, because he just doesn't stop, and Pithy just can't get set.
And if Wiseman Jim was to win, it would be a little lift for South African boxing, which suffered a setback at the weekend when heavyweight Corey Sanders was beaten by Haseem Rahman in America. And we understand that Corey could be retiring.
This is a quiet round, the board a bit tired, but Pithy getting off with a left hook.
Just looked a bit disorganised for a moment there, almost for the first time, Jim. And he walked rather onto a left hook from Pithy.
Well, it's been a very quiet round, apart from that combination from Pithy.
Missing a lot here, Jim. Throwing a lot, but missing a lot. And it's Pithy who does get through with the left hook. Much better punch economy from Pithy. was still, we think, being outscored in the contest as a whole pretty heavily. But this is a good little spell for Pithy here.
Well, it's better for Pithy, but he needs a lot more of it. But I think that was Pithy's round.
Well, we may be seeing something entirely different from the people scoring this fight, Glenn, but if we're right, Dean Pithy needs a knockout or stoppage in the remaining 3 minutes.
Well, most definitely by my call. I've got him 6 points behind. I've never really seen Pithy get into this fight at all. I mean, he's had a few good combinations in the whole fight, and really just Jim has just landed so many more punches and been far busier.
Pithy's been scheduled to go 12 rounds 8 times, Jim never. Pithy's completed those 12 twice, and of course Jim hasn't been this far before, but he doesn't look like slowing up very much. I'll tell you what, whoever came up with this guy as an opponent might face one or two questions tomorrow.
Maybe so. I think he'll face one or two from Pithy.
He certainly will. 12th and final round here. And we think Pithy has to force a stoppage. Now, his corner may think they're watching something completely different, because Spencer Oliver told Adam Smith at the halfway point he had it nearly level. So I don't know how they think it's going.
Well, corners, you know, tend to watch their own men rather than the opponent. They're watching for what they're doing. So Spencer could be forgiven for thinking that.
Fighting with any great urgency like a man who feels he needs a knockout or stoppage, is he, Pithy?
Well, I don't know whether that's maybe because in the middle stages of this fight he'd lost a little bit of heart, because early on everything was going against him.
Let's see if he throws the right hand at all. Don't think he will. Worried about that. That's another psychological problem in there. Of wrestled wise man Jim round there. Jim is due to meet the man that Pithy beat before, Mzonke Fana, in a South African title fight, so we understand. And he might go quite well in that. Would have to start favourite, I guess.
Well, it's getting a bit messy now. This is where Pithy needs to get his arm free, needs some space, let the shots go.
Good southpaw jab there from Jim. It's been a poor performance, this, hasn't it, by Pithy, injury or not?
Yes, it has. But on the other way, it's been a good performance from Jim, who really has went out there to win this fight right from the start, never giving Pithy that much of an opportunity to get in the fight.
Good right hand there from Pithy. Found that shot. Mind you, he'd had to take a couple before that. South Africans are a pretty rough customer as well. Holding Pithy in those tentacle-like arms. He must feel as if he's in there with an octopus at times.
Well, Pithy's doing his fair share of holding, and he's the one that needs to get free and let the punches go.
20 seconds left.
Well, he's done better in the last couple of rounds, Pithy. But I still think he's a long way behind, and, you know, he needs a lot more.
Is Dean Pithy heading for another unscripted defeat here? There's the final bell. It'll go to the scorecards. Pithy looks dispirited, holds his right hand, and Wiseman Jim is lifted aloft by his cornermen. They think they've won it, and frankly, so do we. He threw over 1,000 punches. Look at that, 1,030 punches thrown. Only 185 landed, but that was 40 or so more than Pithy managed. Threw over double the number of shots that Pithy did. Computers are not infallible, of course, but they do, I think, tell a story there. I think there's no doubt about it that Wiseman Jim won that fight. whether we're fighting in Dean Pithy's hometown or not. And to make matters worse, there's another injury. Just to remind you that it's Dave Paris and Paul Thomas scoring this fight, along with the referee, John Coyle. There is John Coyle from Wolverhampton and John McDonald, the MC. And this is going to be a recurring problem. It does raise the question, because Spencer Oliver said to us earlier on the evening they've been a bit worried in the build-up to this fight about that hand. He's just been feeling it a bit. Should he have even been fighting tonight?
Sometimes you do have to go into fights, you know, carrying injuries. That, you know, that's the name of the game. You're never always going to be 100%. Yes,
do you?
You do.
What, even in an intercontinental fight?
Well, it often happens. You know, I'm sure other sportsmen do as well, but often that is the way. It's very difficult. Tickets are sold. Everything's, you know, sometimes you do have to carry it. And you know, every fighter knows that.
Interesting. Could look a very expensive decision in a minute or so's time. Well, that's interesting. That you, if you managed a fighter, you'd let him go in with you with a hand injury.
No, you know, they must have thought that the injury was good enough, and Pithy must have thought it was good enough. I think if he thought it was really bad, he wouldn't have fought. But you know, sometimes if there's a little doubt or a little niggle, you carry that into a fight.
Here comes the decision now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, our two judges and our referee score are as follows. Judge Paul Thomas has scored it 113-116 in favour of Pithy. Judge Dave Paris has scored it 114-116 in favour of Wiseman Jim. And referee John Coyle has scored it 115-115, and we have a draw.
That is frankly outrageous. Absolutely outrageous.
So,
what do you think, Glenn?
Well, Ian, I think it's worse than outrageous. I think to see Pithy the winner of this fight is beyond belief. I honestly cannot see that in any way whatsoever. Watching a wrong fight.
That's got to go to the British Boxing Board of Control, I would suggest. That really, I think, is a decision that besmirches the name of British judging and fairness. That is awful, absolutely awful. How did Paul Thomas see that to Pithy by three rounds?
Well, that was my point. The Paul Thomas seeing that 116-113, I just cannot see that in any way whatsoever. Well, even a draw. I mean, I think Dave Paris had it closer, even a little bit close for comfort.
That's scandalous, really. I think Wiseman Jim won that fight, and everybody here knows it.
Well, the boys are pretty angry about this, but there is a certain unanimity among the judges. Nicky Piper, you're a little further distance from it. Which side are you on, the officials or our commentary team?
The commentary team, no doubt about that. I think it was an outrageous decision. The amount of punches landed showed the stats, and the decision was incorrect. I mean, the South African wise man, Jim, landed more shots. He threw three times as many as Dean Pithy. Had Dean Pithy in trouble on a few occasions. Not badly, but on occasions. So there you are. Well, more than twice as many punches.
OK, but so often when you go into analysis, different pictures emerge. Here's Pithy with 35%
yes.
success ratio yes. to 17 for the man you say won.
Yeah, exactly. Still, but look at the punches landed, 185, 149.
It does underline, though, Nick, that it's a subjective business.
Very subjective.
Briefly, please, on Pithy, how poor a performance?
I'd say a poor performance. I don't think he wanted it as much tonight. Maybe his hand was hurting from the off, I don't know. He certainly lost the first four rounds on most people's cards, so you can't say the injury was something that happened in the fight and was the reason for the bad performance. It either carried in or it was just a bad performance.